wabarakatuh. My name is Nurul Aindin Tino Aslam from Class B. Today I want to talk about evapotranspiration. What is evapotranspiration? Evapotranspiration is a combination of two separate processes, which are evaporation and transpiration. Evaporation is loss of water from the soil surface or any other open water body, and transpiration is from plant surface. The rate of evapotranspiration at any location on the Earth's surface is controlled by several factors. Factors that affect evapotranspiration is environmental factors like air temperature, humidity, and movement of wind and air. First, air temperature. As temperature increases, evapotranspiration also goes up. Second, humidity. As the air becomes more and more saturated, less water is able to evaporate into the air. The humidity gradient away from the surface. The rate and quantity of water vapor entering into the atmosphere both become higher in dry air. Third, movement of wind and air. The wind speed immediately above the surface. The process of evapotranspiration moves water vapor from ground or water surface to an adjacent shallow layer that is only a few centimeters thick. When this layer becomes saturated, evaporation stops. However, wind can remove this layer, replacing it with dry air, which increases the potential for evapotranspiration. Wind also affect evapotranspiration by bringing heat energy into an area. A 5 mile per hour wind will increase still air evapotranspiration by 20%. A 15 mile per hour wind will increase still air evapotranspiration by 50%. Next is water availability. Evapotranspiration cannot occur if water is not available. Less water available means plants begin to transpire less water is an effort to survive. This in turn decreases evapotranspiration. Last one is solar radiation. More solar radiation, more will be the rate of evaporation. Next factors that affect evapotranspiration also plant and crop factors like vegetative cover, leaf shape and size, and type of plant. Evapotranspiration also depends on geographical factors. Evapotranspiration is also dependent upon an area's geography, latitude, and climate. Regions on the globe with the most solar radiation experience more evapotranspiration. Evapotranspiration rates are also highest in areas with a hot and dry climate. And also, evaporation is less in higher latitudes. The last one is soil characteristics. Soil characteristics that can affect evapotranspiration include its heat capacity, soil chemistry, and capillary character. When soil is lacking moisture, plants begin to transpire less water in an effort to survive. This in turn decreases evapotranspiration. Evapotranspiration can be measured by several methods. One of the methods is lysimeter. Lysimeter is a measuring device which can be used to measure the amount of actual evapotranspiration which is released by plants, usually crops or trees. By recording the amount of precipitation that an area received and the amount lost through the soil, the amount of water lost by evapotranspiration can be calculated.